Hello, but why we need to register a system under the physics bundle when this system interacts with the physics? Well, the reason is because the physics engine, as you know, must be stepped with a fixed delta time in order to get a stable simulation. As any other physics engine out here, Amethyst Dispatch is system with a dynamic delta time, so we need a mechanism that takes this dynamic delta time and step the physics correctly. This mechanism is already created and is inside the physics bundle. This means that per each frame that Amethyst Dispatch can happen multiple substeps of the physics. You can have 2, 3, 4 substeps, and this depends from how big the delta time of Amethyst is. Now let's take as example the character motion system that I have created in the previous video. And as you can see here, I am adding forces, impulses and things like that. And if I register this system in the normal pipeline, what happens is that this system is executed just once, while the physics probably is performed 2-3 times per substep. This means that I am adding the forces only on the first physics stepping. This means that the others doesn't receive the force. And as you can imagine, your game doesn't become any more frame independent, and the behavior of the rigid body highly depend on how perform your game. In order to remove this constraint, we have to register this system under the physics bundle. But what is the physics bundle though? Well, the physics bundle is a system which can be called batch because I have the possibility to dispatch some other systems, and its pipeline looks like this one, where we have 3 phases, where in the middle one we have the physics stepping, then we have the pre-physics and the post-physics. As you can imagine, everything you register in the pre-physics happened before the physics step. We want to register the system that interacts actively with the physics, which means adding force, impulses, change velocity or teleport or things like that, before the stepping happens. So this when the physics perform its operation, you already submitted all the input. Rather, when you want to read the result, you have to register the system in the post physics. Must be mentioned that all the system that you are storing, that you are registering under the pre-physics, post-physics dispatching, follow exactly the rules defined by Shred, which means that all the system that you are registering in the pre-physics and post-physics can be run in parallel depending on the resource and on the storages that you are reading or writing. And also, this entire system can be run in parallel with other system that you register in the main pipeline. The pipeline works in this way. We have the main pipeline that dispatch all the system. When it dispatch our physics batch system, this system dispatch multiple times all the system that we have right here, pre-physics and post-physics. It dispatch n times depending on the delta time that we obtain. Once this system is end, then we return back to the main. We have the possibility to also control the stepping, the frame rate of the physics, in order that we can obtain a more precise simulation or less precise but that perform better. This can be done with the function with frame per second, and as default it's set to 60, but you can increase to 100, 200, depends on how you want precise your simulation. Also, down here we have another function which say max substeps per frame. This is basically a safety mechanism. Imagine that this function doesn't exist. So let's imagine that you are loading a mesh, a really big mesh. So for just one frame, you obtain a really big delta time. When you obtain such delta time, the mechanism that step the physics correctly will take all this big delta time and we step the physics probably 100 times. It's likely that the next frame will have an even bigger delta time. The physics engine will step even a lot more, and so. So you keep having a degradation of the performance that can't be stopped. And here enter in game this safety mechanism. Basically, it clamps the number of sub-steps that can happen per each frame. If you watch closely the pipeline that I created here, there is something counterintuitive, because there is a transformation which is registered before the physics bundle. I'm saying that this is, could be counterintuitive because, well, the transformation depends on the physics result, why I want to register it before. Well, the reason is for performance. If we make the transform bundle wait for the physics, we are stopping the entire chain, we can't parallelize nothing. Instead, in order to prevent this problem, what we can do is to register this system before the physics and take the transformation that the physics output in the previous frame, which is basically what happens for the rendering. So it's way better to treat the physics engine like the rendering engine, leaving all the computation performed in parallel with the rendering. Other engines out here perform the computation in this way, but here in Amethyst we have a bit more luck because we have a chain of tasks that can be all parallelized, that go from the rendering to the physics to the system that control the physics. So it's really nice this way. And this is everything regarding the dispatching in Amethyst physics. Thank you, bye.